All right, we're here with Oscar Valdez's dad. So how you feel about his performance against, was it Ruben Tamayo?
Yes.
The Southpaw, right?
Southpaw.
How did you feel about his performance that night?
I think it was a good experience for Oscar. The Southpaw kind of gave him a little bit of trouble, but he pulled it off. He can fight anybody. He can, the styles, it doesn't really matter, as long as we get like 2-3 rounds.
Where's he at right now? What's next for him? I know he's fighting this Friday, I think.
Yes, he's fighting in
Cosmopolitan,
Vegas.
Right?
Yes, fighting him, yes, and with Chris Avalos.
Chris Avalos?
Yes, Chris Avalos, yes.
That's the guy that fought Carl Frampton, huh?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah. So, Oscar, what pushed him into boxing? Was it your love, his love, or was it some fighters that he admired growing up? What was it?
Yeah, when he was growing up, I used to take him to the gym because I used to fight.
Yeah.
So.
What weight?
Welterweight.
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 How many? Did you go pro or anything?
No, because I got a real problem with my stomach, so I couldn't go pro.
Oh, okay.
But,
so you're living out your dream through him, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, so now back to Oscar with how you got into boxing.
Yeah. So he was like 9 years old when he got into boxing, and I used to take him to the gym. So I think from there he started, you know, training, and he started liking it.
Yeah. So. What drives him? I know you guys have a great relationship. You're his backbone. You support him a lot. How important is it that you have this relationship with your son and you support him at all times?
Yes, I think for me it's really important because he was a little kid. He was 8 years old. He wanted to go to the. It's real funny because he wanted to go to the Olympics.
Yeah.
So. I tell you, it's funny because he was just a little boy. So
yeah.
Sometimes kids want to play basketball or baseball. You never know. So I just believe in him since he was a kid. So we did nationals in Mexico and Sonora. So we went to 2 Olympics.
With the Mexican team, right? With the
yes,
Mexican team.
Yes.
Talk to us about that experience and working and dealing with the Mexican National Olympic team.
Well, it's real hard. It's real hard because an amateur is not a real it's not easy. It's,
yeah.
It's real hard to make it in a Mexican team. In state and the Mexican committee is real hard. So this really was hard for us because he was like 16 years old when he beat Carlos Cuadras. So he couldn't make the rules. He has to be like 18 years old. So I put him in. He was 16 years old when he fought Carlos Cuadras.
Yeah, wow.
So it's real exciting, you know, for us to make an accomplishment. It's real hard for us.
You know, a lot of kids, a lot of young, well, people in general, they have pet dogs, pet cats. But it looks like you guys have pet alligators, man. What's the story behind that?
Well, he likes animals, man. He likes tigers, he likes bears, he likes any kind of animal. So the crocodile is real big now.
Yeah.
It's like 2 meters. It's real big.
And it's in you guys' home, in your backyard? Where?
Yeah, we actually have a ranch in Sonora.
Yeah.
So we keep them there.
What do you guys feed them? Like a horse a day or what?
No, we feed them like chicken.
Yeah.
Chicken.
And yeah.
The crocodile doesn't eat much.
Yeah.
You can feed them like once a week, so it's not that hard.
Yeah. All right, last message for the supporters of the Valdez family and team. What would you like to share with them for Friday?
Just to come and see us. Oscar's going to perform well, and to all the Mexicans, you know, especially Sonora and Mexico City, to come to see him fight. It's going to be a great fight.